lot of our Reflect users come from note-taking apps like Evernote or Apple Notes or even something like Google Drive that operates based off of a folder type system. And if you're used to using folders, it can be a little bit of an adjustment to a network note-taking tool like Reflect that operates more off of backlinks and tags for organization. Now, I'm going to show you how to lower that learning curve a little bit and do a bit of a hybrid system that acts like a little bit of folders. But I do want to emphasize that this video is not to encourage you to continue to embrace a folder system as opposed to a network note-taking system, because our brains don't really operate in folders. Sadly, we can't just compartmentalize everything into nice, clean folders. But we've become accustomed to doing that through the applications and digital tools that we use. So I just wanted to give a little bit of a disclaimer there. This is not an excuse to forget about the learning curve with backlinking and using tags, but I do think it significantly lowers that curve and helps get you started and get used to kind of using that system. So let me dive in. There's a couple different things you can do here. The first one I'm going to talk about is doing these pinned notes. So over here on the left here, I've got a couple sample pinned notes. This is just my sandbox brain. It's not my real one. So a lot of these are blank, but I've got the system set up for you to see. So here, these are hypothetical folders. And these are just notes that I have set up and pinned to the left sidebar. And each one of these is basically a table of contents for different things. So here in the projects folder, these are just the projects that I'm working on currently. And each one of these is a backlink. And they're mostly blank because, again, this is just my sample brain, but this is an example of something you could set up a page as a folder. And then instead of just, you know, attaching or putting notes inside the folder, you just backlink to them. And for the record, that's what you always do. You just backlink to them from your daily note. The only difference here is that we have a dedicated note set up that's acting like a bit of a folder. And then we're going to pin it to the left-hand side here just so that we can easily access them. So for Reflect here, I've just got the different components of my work, some things that I work on regularly, like growth ideas, some experiments, a customer support FAQ, where if I don't know the question a customer asks, Alex or someone else from the team can tell me, and then I add it to this list so that I know for next time, maybe growth updates and pieces of feedback that I collect. And similarly in the projects, like I said, I'm just listing all the projects that I'm currently working on. And article drafts, I just thought that was another kind of obvious example for a folder use case where these are just backlinks to hypothetical article drafts. So that's the first one, super easy. The second one is using tags. Now, if we go back to my Reflect note here, you see that I have a projects tag in this. And that is because Reflect is listed under one of these projects. So startup cookie, also projects, all of these have that project tagged in it. And what that means is that we can go to the all notes page, and they don't exactly act like folders, but similar in a way that we're able to set up a table of contents link. I can click on any of these like project and get a list of my projects. Or similarly, I can, you know, get a list of my article drafts or even meetings. That wasn't one that I set up in the example, but, you know, you could theoretically treat that as a folder with meetings. So using both of these things, I think you can get pretty close to using a folder system, or at least something that feels a little bit like it. So play around with these things. I honestly think the first one's probably a little bit easier to get started. And even though it is sort of trying to create a folder system out of an application that doesn't have folders, I do actually think this is a great way to learn the power of backlinking. Because when you start putting these backlinks in here, it becomes more obvious what you would backlink to in your daily note. So for example, if I'm today working on, I don't know, let's say I'm doing a brainstorm for growth ideas for Reflect. So I can say brainstorm growth ideas, actually brainstorm growth ideas. And if I want, I can even put for Reflect there just because I have multiple projects, but this note is already linked to Reflect. And if I were to have you know, growth ideas for multiple projects, I might want to put that in the title, like growth ideas for Reflect, et cetera, et cetera. And then, you know, if I then want to work on an article draft, maybe it's one that I haven't started yet. And so I can say, write draft for article on, trying to think of one that I actually kind of want to write coming up here, but, I don't know, I'll just make up a generic one and say, remote work. And then, once I have my title, Let's say I know what concept I wanna do, and this is gonna be really lame. I'll just create a backlink note and say, the ups and downs of remote work. I can create that, and then go into this and just add my article draft tag, and I'm good to go. So again, this is kind of a stepping stone to help you move from folders into network note taking, but it comes surprisingly fast. It's really only couple days, the first week, where it feels a little bit cumbersome, and then you realize it's so natural and you honestly can't imagine going back to a folder note-taking system.